Greetings from Europe. Lately I've been wondering why I never see automobiles such as SUVs or large pickup trucks here where I live. Most popular European car brands would be BMW, Mercedes. Now over the years watching American movies, I couldn't help but notice stark differences between American and European cars. Going through 5 main differences, I'll explain you guys why are American cars so unpopular in Europe. Because it's literally like, why nobody drives a Ford truck here? Almost nobody. And as a matter of fact, I can answer that question right now. Main reason would be fuel efficiency. It has to do a lot with size as well, but we'll get to that later. Nobody likes to spend a lot on gasoline, you know? Except if you're a wealthy person. European gas prices are substantially higher than American gas costs, but vehicles from United States are not fuel efficient as overseas cars. American families do love their road trips in powerful SUVs that literally burn a hole in a wallet. It is just that the larger vehicles get worse gas mileage. You can drive European vehicle for a longer period of time, but gas price will be higher than in US. While driving an American car, you must refill up a gas tank with fuel much sooner.
Start up, you piece of shit!
Now, do you prefer size or style? There's no denying that in the United States, the bigger is better. I mean, from McDonald's cup sizes to SUVs that give the impression of being larger than life tanks, especially compared to overseas vehicles that are a reflection of small European cities. In Europe, some roads were built by Romans big as was necessary to drive bullock cart. Of course, roads got wider over the centuries, but further widening many streets would be impossible without sacrificing traditional architecture, which is like the last thing on anyone's mind here. While US grabs our attention due to their size, Euro beauty's appearance might get us hooked even more. These cars usually look very beautiful and most modern in the world. You haven't been inside yet, and yet you already know what she feels like inside. I am still talking about the car, am I? Well, these cars tend to look more sleek, more sophisticated, and also more high technology, which I don't find much important in car, but some can really change your mood. As soon as you step inside, it almost feels like in a spaceship. Now, this really comes down to personal opinion, as I actually prefer more a classic look of American cars. Third difference would be quality and price. European cars are a lot more expensive but last longer than American cars. German automakers are known for the highest quality vehicles, well, at least in my country. But maintenance costs for US cars will be a lot cheaper, and parts needed for replacement are usually readily available. Now, if you're looking for a car that has a better handling, perhaps a European car is a better choice, while Americans are still catching up. Some may say that your vehicles must handle better due to smaller roads, but I think it has to do a lot with just better engineering. This results smoother and more enjoyable driving experience and often better safety ratings. Now, I just want to mention, guys, that all these informations are based on random articles and documentaries. But looks like occupants of vehicles meeting European Union safety standards do have a lower risk of serious injury compared with vehicles meeting US standards. Now, last but not least, the biggest difference I've found is difference in transmissions. Getting a driving license in America might be easier due to much more common automatic transmissions. Now, this adds a layer of complexity to majority of European cars, almost all of them that has a manual transmission. This doesn't mean that it's hard to learn manual handling, but making an actual change from automatics to stick shift sometimes can be even impossible. Now, I'm a 19-year-old who still doesn't own a car, which may seem weird if you're American, but public transportation's here literally in every single corner across the Europe. I've been literally taking a bus to school and college now for nearly 10 years and never even thought about getting myself a car until now. Because, you know, as I'm growing up, more eager I am for independence. So in final conclusion, are our American cars better or European cars? Well, in Battle of Continents, neither is necessarily better or worse. There's just a difference in preference. It's like, do you prefer more a bigger car in which you feel like a king? Or do you prefer a sleeker car, more modern with high technology features inside of it? So yeah, I gotta catch my vehicle now that has been recently upgraded with automatic windows. I couldn't get my fridge to work this morning, so I took the bus instead. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video.